Generate a little bit of drag. So for a second or two there, you've got to continue to increase and accelerate in order to get enough flying speed to continue the climb out. When you're out over the water like that, to get that thing off in the minimum allowable distance for takeoff, they had to rotate early and hold it at an exact attitude so that by the time they got to the end of the aircraft carrier deck, keep in mind the deck is moving into the wind, so they're getting it up to speed and it lifts off, but there's nothing but water down below you, so you gotta get out of there, get some altitude so you can push it on over as you saw him do to accelerate quickly. Let's listen to four big radial engines. Sound a little bit like the C-47 that took off. Well, there's a reason for that. Same engines. And when I saw the FM-2 Wildcat flying, that airplane originally used that same engine that you just heard come by, but this one sounds differently. So I suspect that's probably the Curtiss Wright alternative engine that's in the FM-2 Wildcat. The B-25s. Oh, here we go, it's smoking. They used to fly Constellations because they had Curtiss Wright's big radial engines on them, especially the ones in the B-29. So I'm kind of partial to them, but that's what radials are supposed to sound like, in my opinion. Sounds like a room full of Harley Davidsons, and that's what they're supposed to sound like.
I don't know why they got to fly such a damn thing.
C-45. Workhorse transport from Douglas, C-47. Look to the left, you'll see the Boeing B-17. Simulating what the many ground crews saw in World War II. B-17s would come back to their bases, usually in England. Smoke trailing from an engine, or two, or engines shut down because of the flak that they would fly through. German fighters.
Can't bring him in, Charlie, because of C-46. I'll bring Panchito in, Charlie. Cut the other arms in here.
When the Boeing B-17 was first developed and brought out for demonstrate. On the first takeoff, the airplane crashed.
He couldn't make that anyway.
And the press was all over it. They said the reason it crashed is because this airplane is too complex. There's too many things going on for one meager crew. Two pilots and a flight engineer to be able to keep track of everything. Because when they took off, there's a control box that keep the wind from blowing the controls around while it's parked on the ground. So when you park an airplane, you put these control locks on to protect the controls. Well, they did that on the B-17, and they forgot to remove them before flight. So when they took off in the first B-25, trying to impress the government that this was a great airplane that they really ought to buy, the elevator wouldn't operate. The one that makes the nose go up and down because the gust lock, control lock, is still on. So the fix for that situation, to make sure it never happened again, where you take off with the gust locks on, was you put her on a list of things you had to look at and things you had to do before you could start the engines and taxi out and take off. And oh, by the way, even after you started the engines, there's still lots of things you have to do. And so when they had you writing down on the list, they called the list a checklist, to check on all the things that are on this list and make sure you do them for each phase of flight, before flight, during flight, before landing, after landing. So thanks to the B-17 crash on its initial acceptance flight, we have checklists in airplanes, and that's a good thing. C-47 coming by in a photo pass. B-17 looking at the top of the wing as it comes by in a photo pass. Great picture with these puffy white clouds out there in the blue skies. Bombers and transports at the World War II region. Thank you. That's the Yankee Lady from the Air Museum in Michigan. Their B-17 is about to be landed right behind them. Yankee Air Museum in Belleville, Michigan. Normally coming out here with three airplanes, their B-25, their C-47, B-17. And we don't have our B-25, it's a unique B-25 amongst their show B-25s. It's a different model, D model, with a turret on top, back toward the tail. Pretty airplane, we don't see that this year, so they're probably doing maintenance on the airplane. Maybe it's at another air show today. I just touched down into these winds. A little much for a three-point. Nice real landing.
That's
perfect.
Yeah.
Figure, 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 figure